What's up, guys? Brett Medlock here. Once again, sorry about the audio. I keep forgetting to buy a shirt mic, and I'm sorry about that, but I'm going to yell at you as loud as I can, and hopefully it sounds okay. Let me know down in the comments. But anyway, today I wanted to talk about what Nintendo might have up its sleeve for the rest of 2018. If you didn't know, the company has actually gone on record saying that not all games are announced, and they still have surprises to come for this holiday and this year. So what could they be hiding, you know? I'm kind of curious as to why they wouldn't reveal it during E3. I feel like you got all eyes on you. You might want to show off all your big guns whenever everyone's looking, but they decided to focus mostly on Smash Brothers and a little bit of Pokemon and some third-party stuff. But, you know, they might have another big direct planned for a couple months from now, which I made a video about how I think that's what they're going to do. But I'm wondering, what could be in the direct? Well, I have five ideas that I think Nintendo might have planned for the rest of this year, and I'm gonna jump right into it right now. So number one, it's got to be that rumored Star Fox game. You see, this game was so heavily rumored leading up to E3. There were sites like IGN, Nintendo Life, all the biggest like gaming websites were reporting on this rumor as if it was so legit. And like even if you listen to like IGN podcasts, there's a guy on there named Pear. He's like a higher up at IGN. He always talks about stuff that's secretly real, but we don't really know it whenever they're talking about it. And he was talking about the rumored Star Fox Grand Prix racing game as if it was real. So maybe it's not, maybe it is. I honestly hope it's real. I want to see another Star Fox game. I could not get into the previous Star Fox game on Wii U. Star Fox Zero, it just wasn't my bag. But I think if they brought the series into a racing style genre, rumor was that you would be racing and then there would be stuff on the track that you could shoot at, and then the more stuff you shot, the faster you would go, and I think that sounds really cool. I don't know exactly all the details, because once again, there's not really much to go off of, but I really think that that Star Fox game is real, and if it doesn't come out this year, I think that it's going to get announced at the next Direct, which will be in a couple months from now, and then it'll maybe come out like early next year, March or something like that. But anyway, the second thing that I think Nintendo might have up its sleeve is, of course, the Nintendo 64 Classic. A while back, Nintendo trademarked the N64 Classic Edition or something like that, and it got everyone thinking, if they do this, I'm gonna be so excited, because the Nintendo 64 has so many great multiplayer games, and I know a bunch of people my age, like 25 to 30, hell, even people in their early 20s probably played so much N64 whenever they were a kid. And I think it'd be perfect for this holiday season. The one thing I'm hoping is that there's not a bunch of supply restraints, because I think the Nintendo 64 Classic would actually sell the most, which is very odd considering that the N64 sold less than the SNES and the NES. But I think the N64 Classic will hit that nostalgia factor for so many adults nowadays, where it would sell so good during the holiday time. And I really hope that if this does happen, that Nintendo stocks them and has plenty of them to sell, because it sucks not being able to find this stuff on the market, the stuff you really want to play, the stuff you're really excited about. And it would follow the trend that Nintendo has been doing with the NES, the SNES, and now the N64 Classic. I think around the holiday time is the perfect time to launch it. I want to make a video talking about the games that I think should be on the list of 20, 30 games. I don't know how much we're really gonna get, but I think it'd be really cool. Would it come with four controllers? I highly doubt it, but hell, maybe they'd have a bundle or something for like $100, you get the console and four controllers. I think that would be really cool. But let me know what you think down in the comments about the N64 Classic. Do you think it's coming out this year, maybe next year? We know it's coming, honestly. Like, I feel like Nintendo has been holding off on putting classic games on the eShop on the Switch because of the fact that they want to go through all these mini consoles before they roll out that stuff on Switch. Because you know so many people are going to double dip. They're going to buy the N64 Classic and they're going to buy N64 games on Switch. And Nintendo knows that and they're not dumb. Now, number three, we haven't gotten any multiplayer Mario games on Switch yet. And I think this is where we'll get another port of either New Super Mario Bros. Or Super Mario 3D World, or maybe both. You know, maybe they'll bundle them together because these are great games. The Wii U didn't sell very good, so I'm guessing not a lot of people got their hands on them. And I think a bunch of new Switch owners would love to play them with their friends and with their family on Switch, because people just love the Switch hardware a lot more than the Wii U, let's be honest. And not having that many Wii U units sold, these games still sold pretty good on Wii U, and a lot of people love them. They received like critically acclaimed multiplayer Mario games, and they're a blast. You know, I played them on Wii U, I love them. And I think they would fit right at home on the Switch. And we need a multiplayer Mario game. That's something that we're severely lacking on Switch right now. And I think it would make a ton of sense. Now, number four, this one's really related to those two Mario games. And it's because it's Super Mario Maker. We got Super Mario Maker on Wii U. I absolutely adored that game. I played it so much. Then we got it on 3DS. I skipped out on that one because I heard it was weird with the online stuff, or there wasn't no online or something like that. And I want to jump back into that. I want to start building stuff on the Switch version. I want to use the touchscreen and then put it into my TV and play those levels. I want to play other people's levels more. I think Super Mario Maker could be one of them, like, games as service titles where they're constantly updating it, constantly adding new stuff. They did that for a while on the Wii U version. I think if they brought it to Switch, they could just keep adding a bunch of stuff and people could let their imaginations run wild. And it would probably do really good on the Switch, let's be honest. The Switch first-party games are selling really great, and I think Super Mario Maker makes a lot of sense for the holiday season. Anything Mario-related makes sense for the holiday season, and I think Nintendo is going to bring this game sooner or later to Switch, because Super Mario Maker on Wii U was, like, a big deal when it came out. It won a bunch of awards, like Game of the Year awards. Like, it's just incredible. It's an amazing game on last-generation hardware that people would probably jump back into on the Switch. Now, my last one is Smash Brothers related. So if you didn't know, leading up to E3, there was actually a user on GameFAQs who actually said and guessed every single thing that happened in the Nintendo Direct about Smash Brothers. He said, all the characters are coming back, you're gonna get Snake back, there's going to be the Ice Climbers returning. And most important of them all, he said that Ridley will be included in the game for the first time. And you know, maybe a person may have been able to guess that along with all the other characters in Smash, but if you look at the guy's history, he actually posted another post before the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles got announced for Injustice. He said that that was going to happen, and what do you know, it ended up happening. And then a little while after that, he did this Smash Brothers rumor or leak or whatever, and every single thing on his list has come true except one very important thing, which is that Simon Belmont from Castlevania is going to be in the game. And that would honestly not surprise me, because Nintendo and Konami, they've had a pretty good relationship lately. We got Super Bomberman R, and then we got Snake back in Smash Brothers. And not only that, but Super Bomberman is a trophy in Smash Brothers, who I personally think should be a playable character, but we'll talk about that some other time. But I think this would make sense. Simon Belmont is a big deal. Castlevania is a big deal. They've been getting all the classic characters, Pac-Man, Sonic, Mega Man. They're all there, except Simon Belmont. It makes so much sense to put him in Smash Brothers, and it really excites me. I really think this is going to happen. I think there's another Direct happening. I wouldn't be surprised if this was the opening thing or the finale. Simon Belmont would be incredible in my opinion, but be sure to let me know what you think down in the comment section below. How do you feel about my 5 predictions about the rumored Star Fox game being real and coming out maybe later this year or at the beginning of next year, about new Super Mario Brothers U coming to Switch or Super Mario 3D World as well, and along with Super Mario Maker, and do you expect to see Simon Belmont from Castlevania in Smash Brothers, and of course the N64 classic coming later this year for the holiday season. That's all I really got to talk about today, guys. Thanks a lot for watching this video. Be sure to let me know your predictions for Nintendo for the rest of the year down in the comments section below. Please hit that subscribe button if you enjoy this video, and be sure to give me feedback. I love feedback. I eat it up. So thanks a lot. I will talk to you guys later.